In today's video, we are making this clear body wash, which I love so much, and I am so obsessed with this body wash. It came out really good and it was so nice and very good on the skin. I can actually tell you that this is one of my best ever made body wash recipe. So you definitely want to watch this video to the end because this is not your regular body wash. Let's get right into the video. To get started, I'll place a clean beaker on my scale to measure out my ingredients, and I'll be starting with my Pase A ingredients. For my Pase A, I'm going to pour in some distilled water into my beaker. I'm using 200 grams of my distilled water. I have 237 grams of my distilled water in my recipe, but I'll use 200 grams first. I'll use the remaining grams to dissolve my actives later on. Then I will add in 50 grams of my glycerine into my distilled water. Glycerine in this recipe will help to hydrate the skin and moisturize the skin and will not leave the skin dry after using this body wash. I will set my Pase A aside, then I'll measure out my Pase B. For my Pase B, I'll place a clean beaker on my scale to measure out my ingredients. And the first ingredients I will add into the beaker is my SCI powder. I am using 30 grams of my SCI powder. SCI powder is also known as sodium cocoa isotonic powder. It is an anionic surfactant that helps to cleanse the skin. It has a very good cleansing property and it is gentle on the skin. It is a very nice surfactant that you can use. You can also replace your SCI powder with your SLS powder if you don't have SCI. After measuring my SCI powder, I will add in my next ingredient, which is my cocobetaine. I'm using 150 grams of my cocobetaine. Cocobetaine is an amphoteric surfactant that also helps to cleanse the skin. It will add a rich and creamy lather to our soap. It's a very, very lovely surfactant as well. Cocobetaine, I don't think you can replace cocobetaine with anything because cocobetaine is mostly used in cleansing products as a co-surfactant. So you should definitely use cocobetaine. After measuring my cocobetaine, this is my Pase B. I am going to stir my SCI powder and my cocobetaine together to make sure it is well combined together. And then I'll grab my Pase A and I will take the two phases to my double boiler to heat the two phases up until it is well heated. So here are my Pase A and my Pase B in my double boiler. I am stirring together my Pase B, which is my SCI and my cocobutane, because the SCI powder has some chunks in there. So I'll keep stirring together until it is dissolved and it is well heated. Here is my Pase A and my Pase B. The two phases are well heated up. So the next thing I will do is I'll be adding in my Pase B into my Pase A. And then I'm going to stir the two phases together to combine. But while you stir this together, it's not going to easily, you know, mix together. What you will do is you will stir for some time, you leave it, and then you come back again to stir again, then you leave it like that, until the two phases are well combined together. So it is well combined now. And the next thing I will do is I will set this aside because this is still very hot. I'll set it aside, then I'll prepare my next phase ingredients. For my Pase C, I'll place another beaker on my scale to measure out some distilled water. So this is the remaining distilled water that I have left from my Pase A. So I will use this to dissolve my active powders. I will set the water aside and place another container on my scale to measure out my active powder. And for my active powder, the first one I will use is my licorice. I am using 10 grams of my licorice. Licorice has soothing effect on the skin. It helps to ease inflammation. Licorice helps to boost dull skin and it also helps to brighten up the skin. So which is why I decided to use licorice, and it came out really nice. It was lovely in the body wash. So I'll pour my licorice into my water, and then I'll stir together to dissolve. This is actually going to take some time to dissolve. Then I will set this aside to measure out my other powder. The other powder I'll be pairing together with my licorice is my niacinamide powder. Niacinamide helps to boost collagen production. It helps to improve the skin texture. It helps to brighten up the skin and fade hyperpigmentation. Niacinamide also helps to boost skin hydration. So, which is a lovely ingredient, and I decided to pair it together with my licorice. I'll pour my niacinamide into my licorice mist, and I will stir together. The two will not really look clear. This is supposed to dissolve and look very clear, but it's not really going to look clear because the water that I use to dissolve it is actually small. So it might not come out looking clear, but it's definitely going to dissolve. Then I'll place my beaker back on my scale to add in my next ingredient, which is my germall plus preservative to preserve my body wash. I will stir together very well to combine, and then I'm going to pour this into my soap. I'll just get my soap. So this is my soap. It has started to cool down, and it has cooled down very well for me to add in the next ingredient, because this ingredient I want to add are heat sensitive ingredients, so which is why I did not add it then while the soap was still very hot. I will stir my mixture together, and I'll pour this into my soap, and I'll be mixing together to make sure it is thoroughly combined. Together, this is it. Everything is well combined, and this is my body wash. But we are not going to pack up this body wash yet. What I will do is I'll cover this my body wash till the next day so that it can settle and it can become clear. You can see from the beginning of this video that we have a clear body wash. So this is like a day after making the mixture. If you want to make this body wash, your second name have to be patience, because you have to keep this till the next day to make sure your body wash has settled and it is looking clear, just like this. And this is it. Our body wash is ready at this point. This is the, you know, this is the consistency that I want, and it looks very good. And to spice something up, I will add in some color in there. You can use your body wash clear if you don't want to add in color, but we want to use a body wash without color. The color gives it the beauty, and you know, it looks pleasing to the eye. Then I added in my red color. If you want to make this body wash and you want it to look clear just the way mine is, I would advise you use a color that is water-based. Don't use your mica powder. Your mica powder will give you one kind of shiny look, and it's not really going to look so clear like that. So use a water-based color. I will stir my color into my body wash properly to combine, and look at this gorgeous, beautiful body wash. Everything about this body wash is an A1 because I love it so much. Let me show you a closer look of this body wash. Just look at it. Look at how gorgeous it looks, and I love it so much. I am so obsessed. It came out really nice, and it was so good on the skin as well. If you notice that I did not use any fragrance oil in this body wash. I don't want to use fragrance oil. I don't want the fragrance oil to spoil like the clear of this, like the clearness, is it clearness or clarity of this body wash for me. So you can decide to use fragrance oil in your own, but I decide not to use fragrance oil. Then I'll check my pH of my body wash, which I got a pH 6, and it was just perfect for me. The next thing I will do is I'll store my body wash in a clean bottle, and it is ready. We've made a beautiful body wash. Let me call this body wash a brightening, and you know, a glowing body wash, because you are definitely going to love this. It came out really good, and it was very perfect on my skin. I love it so much. And look at it. Look at the clear body wash that we just made. This body wash actually settled more than this the following day, and it looks more clearer and more beautiful. So let me show you how much this body wash lathers so well, and I love it. If you have watched this video to this point, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate you. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please don't forget to hit that subscribe button for me. And if you're a returning viewer, thank you so much for always coming back to watch my videos. I really appreciate you. I hope to see you all in my next one. Bye.